मैसेज इन द व्हाट्सएप सर.
ओके सो ओके सो टुडे वी विल सी सेलेनियम राइट एंड वी विल डू एन हाइब्रिड फ्रेमवर्क. ओके सो हाइब्रिड दिस हाइब्रिड फ्रेमवर्क सो वी आर डूइंग द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ पेज ऑब्जेक्ट मॉडल सो एंड वी विल डू विद द डेटा ड्रिवन. ओके एंड वी विल यूज बिहेव फॉर द बीडी फ्रेमवर्क. So we are going to combine these three things and we are going to form one framework. Okay, so that is what we are going to see here. First, for that, what you should do is you should can you go to Google, and if you go to Google and you should install Python. That will be your first step. Since we already installed, we are not installing again. So first is right. First we should do right. First is PyCharm you download. You should go to this link, the first link. And you should go there and just give community version, right? You should install the community version. So this is the first step you have to do for the installation part. Okay. Next, after you doing this one, this is the first one. Community version. Make sure it's a free version you are using. So install the community version, not the professional version. Okay. Next, after that, the second step will be: can you go to Google again and you download Python? Python download. Python download, right? So we already had the Python now machine. Okay, so you can go here, click here. Okay, so you can see, right, the first tab, right, button you have, right, download Python 3.90 or 3.9.0, right? So you can download that version and what OS bit you have, you can choose according like Mac, Windows, right, whatever version you are having, and you should go there. Click the exe, run it. It's a basic step, I think. Hope everybody knows, right? So you just go there and click it, and install it, and you should set the environment variables. Okay. So this is how it will take some time, just like 2 to 3 minutes will take. So right. So at first you should install Python, then the PyCharm. So you should install both these things. This will be our basic step. Since we already installed, we are not going. So make sure, kindly make sure installing both the Python and also the PyCharm. Okay, so PyCharm is an IDE like Eclipse, right? In Selenium Java, we have an IDE. We use IntelliJ and Eclipse, right? Same thing in our right. In our Python, we have different IDEs, right? We have Spider, we have PyCharm. So we are currently using PyCharm now. So now, okay. Next, close this window. Then we'll go open the PyCharm, which is already installed in our machine. So this is the machine which we created. Okay, let's start a new project, namely hybrid. A new project. Okay, so let's name it as hybrid. Right, right. Behave framework. Right, BDD framework. Behave framework. Yeah. Okay, let's start. Let this name it as hybrid behave framework. So if we are going to do with a multiple framework, combination of multiple framework like data driven. Right, page object model is not a framework, it's a design pattern, and then we are going to combine with data driven, right? Okay, so we can also use PyTest, but we are not using PyTest here. PyTest is like a test engine in our Java, right? So PyTest is also one framework. Okay, so next click create. Okay, new window. Okay, so this will be this is how you create right the project, right? So we are going to create a project. Okay, now if you notice, right, a project has been created in the website, right? So now we expand the project. Now first thing what you should do is we should install all the Selenium right packages, right? For that, what we should do, we should go to file. Okay, in file you should go to settings. Okay, in your Python interpreter, right, you just go and you have a top right side, you have plus symbol, right? So you should go to that, click that plus symbol. and you type selenium here. Okay, you should type selenium here. So you can see all the packages of the selenium, right? First you go and click the selenium there, and you left side bottom you see install package, right? You click install package. Can you click install package? Okay, package installed successfully, right? And if you want the Chrome browser, everything, right? If you want, you can install it, but all the packages comes within this selenium. Okay, next, can you go to the to open the notepad which we have? Okay, so these are the right packages we need to install for the our framework. First one is a selenium. Next one is your behave for BDD, right? Where you want to install behave. Next, we want to install Allure for reporting. Okay, we are going to do Allure report. Hope you have heard Extend report, Allure report, Cucumber report in Selenium Java, right? So here in our framework, this framework, we are using Allure report. Next, if you want HTML report, we can generate HTML report also. And next, we are installing the web driver manager to download the latest drivers, right? So these are the like five packages which you are going to do now, install now. So we already did Selenium. Now we'll go install Behave. Okay, click install package. Okay, you can see, right, behave installed successfully, you can note it. Now, we'll go to the pip command first, right, pip should be ready, pip should be in your machine, right? Now, we'll go to the pip command, right? Can you go to the terminal? Okay, now, next we'll install the, this one, right? Hey, Allure report will do. For that, you should use this command, pip install Allure behave. Give that and click enter. So for that, in your PyCharm you have a terminal, right? That you can give. Okay, and see successfully installed Allure behave, and the version is 2.8.22. okay, so we are installing Allure behavior. Okay, so we are installed Allure report. So this is for reporting. Allure behave is for reporting. Okay, next we'll go to the notepad. Next, we'll install the HTML report also. For that, this is the command. Pip write install pytest-html. Okay. So if you notice, pip install pytest-html. Okay. Now, can you click enter? So this is also successfully installed. The HTML reporting also is successfully installed. Okay. So next, can you go to the notepad again? Okay, now we should do the web driver manager, right? This is, you all know, right? This is for downloading the latest drivers, okay? So now go there and install this one. Okay, now click. Okay, now we install, right? Okay, now it's installed, right? So you can see, right, successfully installed, okay? So now this web driver manager is also installed, and the 3.2.2 version is also installed here, okay? So now we installed all the packages. Now let us create the structure of the framework. Can you go to the notepad here? See, if you notice, these are the structures we are planned here. First is you should create a new project, then you should create the folders. What are the folders we are planning here is, first is the future file, where we write the scenarios, right? The test cases we write, future file. Next one is here in Selenium, Java, we see like config property. Same thing, we'll have the config property here in this configuration folder. Next one is we can generate logs, right? For that, we create one folder logs. Next one is we write pages, right? The pages class will be there, where the pages methods and your locators will be there in your page class, right? So we are using the page folder here. Next one is we'll have a report folder where we'll generate the ALU report, we'll keep all your ALU report and HTML report. Next one is we'll have screenshot where we'll take screenshot for the past and the pain test case. Right, screenshot we can take, right? For that also we can do. Next one is your test data. Okay, so we'll have the test data. Next one is we'll have the right test we'll have. Next one is we'll have the other utility classes like logger we'll have, okay? Config property for that, the classes, the code will be there. So these are the structure of our project. And we'll have the run.bat, we'll have the command where to execute the code. So this is what is the structure we are planning here for this thing, okay? So this is a basic framework. Still we'll explore right more according to the requirement, okay? So what application we planned here to automate is, can you go to Google? Okay, so this, right, C2TA, right, you have an application, our own personal application, right? Can you go and give an address bar, please? Okay, C2TA, right? C2TA.co.in, right? This is our own personal application, right? Click the first one.
Okay. So this is our site. Right, if you go to site, right, C2TA, right, co.in, and we have a practice page here. This is free only. So if you want to learn all the Selenium concepts, right, so if you like input time learning, radio button, checkbox, right, you can enroll this course, right, alerts, frame handling, okay, so actions, keyboard mouse operations, right, scroll down. You can try scroll down also. So the different write methods you can try in this page. So it's a free course. You can enroll and you can start practicing this one. So this is our personal site actually. And the for this framework, what we plan is, you can go up. Can you scroll up? There is a two buttons, right? The login and link, right? Login and register. So we'll try to automate that login and register with the help of this framework. We'll try step by step, okay? So this is what I'm planning for this right particular framework. Okay, let us go to the PyCharm now. Let us create our folders there. Okay, so now, right, so this is the practice page which you are talking, and this is so you can go through all this right menus, right for learning on the Selenium page. Okay, so as I told, we are going to do the login functionality and the register functionality of this page. So this is what we are planning for this hybrid framework. Okay, so now let us go to the PyCharm. Okay, now we'll go to right click on the hybrid framework. We'll create the folders now as we showed earlier. Okay, so first we'll create a folder. Okay, one click the folder. Create a folder name called as Futures. Okay, for next we'll create another folder. Okay, Pages. Okay, next we'll create another folder. Right step preparation. Okay, next we'll create another folder, okay, reports. Okay, next we'll create another folder, right, screenshots. Next, we have another folder, right? Logs we have, right? Logs. Okay, then we'll have utilities. Then we'll have test data. If it is needed, we'll have test data also. So these are all our folders in our project. As I told you, this is a hybrid framework, right? Combination of two, more than one framework is called as a hybrid framework. So we are going to combine three things here. One is BDD, next one is page object model. Okay. So then data driven. So these three things we are going to combine our framework here. So first we'll create a future file. Can you go there? I'm going to create a file, future file there. Right, like your login dot feature. Okay, so we created a feature file we created. Next one is we'll create pages there. Yeah, Python file. We create a Python file. We'll create a write login dot write login dot file. The extension of write Python is dot py, right? Login page dot py. Now let us create a step definition also. I think we missed the configuration folder. Configuration folder. So we write configuration code is also there. Now we'll have a step definition. We'll create a step definition class. And we should have the run dot button. The run dot button will do data. Okay, we'll have a write the step definition, right? Step definition we'll have for login steps. So what we'll do is, can you go open the future folder? So here itself we'll have a step definition in the folder itself. Can you right click on the future folder? Just here create a directory steps. Step definition will keep in the future file, not like what we do in the Selenium Java. Okay. So here itself we'll have the steps. Okay. Now, can you go to the login feature? We'll create the scenario also. Okay. Now, can you go to Notepad? I think we already created the scenario, right? So there we are automatically going to run for the two scenarios. One is verifying the home page and the title. Okay. Next is here login functionality of a C2T application. Okay. So this is the first is the feature file. The feature is the description of your scenario is feature application is to test the C2T application. Next was first test case is to verify the home page. Okay. And the given condition, right? The precondition, launch the browser and navigate to the URL, right? The launch the browser. Okay. Next is then condition is verify the page title. So then condition is right your action, right? You do in when and then is the result, right? To verify the page title and uncondition you close the browser. Same thing we are doing for another scenario. Two scenarios we are trying to automate here. First is next is your verify login functionality. Next is given launch the application. Okay. Next your action, right? First is a precondition, next one is your action, and third one is your outcome, right? So when is enter the login credentials, then is click the login button. Next is then verify the page title and take the screenshot. Okay. And next one is close the application. So these are the two scenarios which you are trying to do in our framework. Can you copy this feature file, both the scenarios? And you just copy and you paste in the feature file.
Okay. Now, can you go to the pages? Have two pages with you. Okay, one is a login page, and next one is your home page. So we'll have two pages. Can you go and create a configuration config.ini file? Okay. So we'll have the configuration config.ini file. Okay. Next one we'll have the utilities. Can you go to the utilities? No need of step definition folder, we'll delete it. Since we are having steps in the light feature file itself, we are deleting, no need. Okay, delete this one. Can you go to the utilities?
Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll go to the configuration folder and go and click config.ini. So you go to the notepad. I think what we do is, okay, we'll have the config properties, right? In Selenium Java we do, right? So we could keep our base URL, right? What browser we are going to launch or something, you remember, right? So we keep and write the attributes also, the values, right? What our values we are passing in the application, right? That also we keep in your config.property. We can keep in our scenario outline also. So we both will see how to take from the config.property and also from the scenarios also directly we can pass in the feature file also. Can you copy and paste there in the config.property in the INF file? Okay. So as I told you, this c2ta.co.in, this application only we are going to use it. For the login credentials, right, we are going to use guest and guest 123. So this is the login credentials we are going to use for our application, right? Site c2ta.co.in. Next, we are going to the utilities and we are creating two classes, okay? One is custom logger.py, okay? And the next one is we'll have the read property.py, okay? So the custom logger is for logging the your report, right? So it's for a logger, which you used to generate for all your functionalities, which you work in your pages and the test cases, right? So can you go to the logger and can you create one file in the utilities, custom logger.py, right? Custom logger.py. Can you go there and can you go to the notepad and paste the code and can you paste it here? Can you paste it? Okay, so right, so we create one class called as log generator. This is for generating your logs in your application, right? So like suppose, right, you can print in the console, right? Browser has been launched, right? Or URL has been launched, or right, your username and password has been entered. Login has been successful. If you want to generate log in your results, right? And also, if you want to know about what is the time it executed, right? Time, date, format it executed. Okay. If you want to know that, so you can give all those things in your right in your class file, and you can use static method for that. Okay. So and this will be a general format, right? You can download, you can Google it, and you can take this format, right? From the 8th line to the 11th line, you can take from the Google, right? So this format we'll be using for generating our logs. Okay. Then we create one right reference logger equal to logging.getLogger. GetLogger will get the logs, okay? And write a handler, right? We use handler and set level, right? Logging.info. We know, right? In the Selenium Java, we have sort logging.warning, which saw info, we have saw on, right? Past, frame. Like that, we have some different right information, right? So that we can pass here and we are returning here. So this is one file where we generate our logs, right? We give the path of the right the log file what you want. If you see, right, the file name equal to logs slash c2ta automation log dot. So this is the file name where we want to generate our logs. Logs hyphen, right from the 11th line, if you notice, right, logs hyphen C2TA automation log. So in this file only, automatically when you start executing a SIPs, an automatic logger will be generated and stored in that particular path. This path we are taking from the folder of the log folder and right clicking, taking the path, and we are pasting here. So this is a class for generating your logs. Slowly you'll see where it's applied in our execution part. Okay. Now scan, you can go to utilities and create another PI file, readProperty.py. So this is like same thing like config properties, right? Which we have in our Selenium Java, right? So this is a config property, right? So this is code for generating the config, right? Properties, okay? Can you go there and paste now the read property? So first, basically what we are giving here is, okay? So, right, we import config parser there, okay? Then we are giving the path of the config.inf file, right? If you go and see, we'll take the, I think you should change configuration, and here it's configuration. The third line, right? You change it to configuration. Can you take the path now? Copy, right? Copy path, okay? Then copy the path, and you should path from the content root. Okay, take the path and go there and give the path there. Okay, you can give the opposite slash also, double slash. Can you remove that configuration? Right, yeah, give that, right. Ah, that's fine. Okay, I think you are fine now. Okay, so you give that. Okay, next we are creating in class read config. Okay, so next, after that, we are using a static method there. Then we'll create three methods. One is for getting the URL. Okay. Next is write get this URL getter methods, right? Next one is write getting the username. And next one is getting the password. Okay. This URL where you are giving in the config.ini. Can you go to config.ini now? Okay. You can see, right? Base URL https c2ta. Code.in. Okay, so this URL you are getting from the read property. Okay, you go to the read property and you see username and password, right? So all these three right values you are getting from here. Okay, so URL config.get method config common.info, comma base URL. Okay, the next one is if you see right username equal to config.get common info, comma username. Okay. So whatever you want to pass in the config method, for that you should create a corresponding static method here. Okay. Then you should pass the values in your config.file. Okay. Suppose there are some 5 pages in your application. For all those things, you can pass your by the values here. Okay. So whatever you want to pass, right? So you can pass the values here. You can keep in a separate file rather than writing in a code. But if you are, as we told, right, in the future file also, we can have a scenario outline where we can pass all the username and password. Mostly common properties like URL, okay, so the browser and all, we can keep in the config.ini, okay. So this is what we do, okay. This is the general practice what the industry follows in the application, okay. So today, I will stop this one, okay. So just here today, what we saw is how to install the Selenium Python, what are the packages you have to install, okay? Then we created a simple framework, right? Simple structure of framework, okay? Hybrid behavior framework, where we created all the folders like, if you see, right? Futures, configurations, logs, pages, reports, screenshots, test data, test utilities, and run.bat will create it on the next video. And we created a future file with two scenarios, Okay, one is the home page. Next is right checking the functionality of a home page, right? Whether you get the title or not. Next one is checking the login functionality where you enter your username and password and see whether it's navigating the next page and you are getting the title and screenshot and closing that. Okay. Next, we saw the common configuration properties where we create in a separate file and we'll pass it to a script. So this is what, as for that we create one file config.ini. Okay. Next, if you scroll down, next we create a logger file where we'll generate the logs for our in our test scripts, right? So whenever we want, we can call this logger method and we can generate the logs for the corresponding with the date and time with the timestamp, right? You can write with this timestamp, we can get the time and the message, whatever message you want to pass it, you can pass with the help of this logger file. Okay. Next one, you have the read property where we use the getter method, right? So get username and the get password and the get URL. So we give right, we create a method and we give a method name and we get the we get the properties from the config.ini. Okay, so this is the basic structure we saw today, and we'll see tomorrow regarding the pages, how to create pages with the page factory and how to generate steps, and we'll generate Allure report. Okay, and we'll try to execute in the command line. So this is what is the plan for the next video. So see you. Thank you.